Father and our God, we bless your name as we go into your word again today. Send forth your word by the power of the Holy Spirit and let it save the souls of the children of men into your kingdom. In Jesus' name I pray. We still continue to talk about walking in love to your parents. And like I said to us before, to walk in love means to obey the commandments of God. Like I said before, if you love God and love your parents, you'll obey the laws that God has set down to govern the parent-children relationship. Likewise, like I've said earlier on, if you love God and you love your spouse, you'll obey all the regulations and laws that God has set down to govern the marital relationship. Now that we are talking about walking in love with your parents, the same thing is applicable. If you love God and you love your parents, you're going to walk in obedience to all the laws that God has set down to govern the parent-children relationship. Today, let's begin with Proverbs chapter 1, verse 8. My son, hear the instruction of thy father, and forsake not the law of thy mother. This is a clear command for children to obey their fathers and mothers. God expects you as a child under the tutelage of your parents to obey the instructions of your father and the laws or instructions of your mother. If you do this, God will bless you for it. That's what the Bible says. Hallelujah. When you disobey your parents, you give them sorrow and agony of heart. And that is contrary to love. It does not agree with love at all. Let's go on to Proverbs chapter 6, verse 20. My son, keep thy father's commandment, and forsake not the law of thy mother. Now let's go to Proverbs 23, verse 22. Hearken unto thy father that begat thee, and despise not thy mother when she is old. That's a clear commandment of God, to hearken unto your father who gave birth to you, and to your mother who carried you in her womb for about 9 months. The Bible says, do not despise them when they are old. Hallelujah. When they are old and positions have changed, and instead of they taking care of you, you are now the one taking care of them. And sometimes when they are very old and dotage sets in and maybe they begin to do some unreasonable things because of dotage or whatsoever, the Bible says, do not despise them. Hallelujah. God requires it from you to treat your parents with honor all the days of your life. No matter how old you become, treat your parents with great honor and great respect. Remember that as you are getting old, your parents are not getting younger. They are still getting old also. Hallelujah. When your parents correct you, when your parents correct you or rebuke you or even whip you as a child, understand that it is because they love you and they want everything to be good for you, both presently and in all your future. Let's go to Proverbs chapter 3, verses 11 and 12. My son, despise not the chastening of the Lord, neither be weary of his correction. For whom the Lord loveth, he correcteth, even as a father, the son in whom he delighteth. So that's it. A father and a mother, likewise, both correct their children because they love them and they want everything to be okay for them presently and in future. Let's go to Proverbs chapter 29, verse 15. The rod and reproof give wisdom, but a child left to himself bringeth her mother to shame. You see, when parents flog you or rebuke you or reprove you, and you take it joyfully, you will get wiser and wiser and wiser. But if they do not reprove you or rebuke you or correct you, and they leave you to go on to revel in your foolishness, it will cause problems for you in your future. It will affect your present and your future. It will hinder your progress in life. And invariably, it will make you an embarrassment, not just to yourself, but even to your parents, your mother, and your father. That's why it says the rod and reproof give wisdom, but a child left to himself bringeth her mother to shame. How does the child bring her mother to shame? By doing what is embarrassing, what is ungodly, what is evil, what is shameful. Hallelujah. This is why parents must not go by modernism, but they must go by the word of God. They must correct their children in the biblical way so that the future of the children can be beautiful as God wants. Hallelujah. Whether you are in your preteens, whether you are in the teenage, whether you are above the teenage, as long as you are under the authority and tutelage of your parents, allow them to reprove you, to correct you, to rebuke you. Take it gladly when they do so, because it is for your good, it is for your prosperity, it is to make your tomorrow to be great, to the glory of the living God. Hallelujah. Friend, it is for your advantage to obey your parents. Don't get involved with the influence of evil spirits, which is manifesting in the last days and making children to be disobedient and rebellious to their parents. Do not allow this in your life, young man, young woman, precious boy, precious girl, little boy, little girl. Do not allow this in your life, because it is not going to work for your betterment or success. Disobedience to parents will work for your ruination, for your destruction. It will work out things that will mess up your future. Do not permit that. Hallelujah. Let's go to Proverbs chapter 13, verse 1. A wise son heareth his father's instruction, but his corner heareth not rebuke. This is another testimony of the scriptures confirming that it is for your advantage as a child to submit yourself to the corrections, to the tutelage, to the rebuke of your parents. If you do so, it will work out to give you a great future, success in life. If you do not cooperate with this, it is going to work out for your destruction and the ruination of your future. Do not allow that. Do not allow the bad influence of the spirit of the age that makes children to be disobedient and rebellious to their parents. Do not allow that in your life. Walk in the wisdom of God as seen in the Holy Scriptures. Hallelujah. Whether you are in the preteen or you are in the teenage or above the teenage, submit yourself to the authority of your parents. It is for your good. It is for your benefit. Let's go to Proverbs chapter 15, verse 5. A fool despiseth his father's instruction, but he that regardeth reproof is prudent. Now, this is telling us that a child who despises his father or mother's instruction is a fool. That's what the Bible calls that kind of child. Bible calls him a fool because he's in a pathway of self-ruination and self-destruction. Don't do that to yourself. I read again. A fool despiseth his father's instruction, but he that regardeth reproof is prudent. A child who accepts the correction, the reproof, or rebuke of his parents is a prudent child. The Holy Spirit in the Holy Scriptures called that child prudent. That means wise. Walk in the wisdom of God. Oh, little boy, little girl, precious boy, precious girl, preteen, teenager, or you are above the teenage, walk in the wisdom of the Holy Spirit. As long as you are under the tutelage of your parents, God requires of you to submit to them unquestionably. As long as they do not ask you to do anything that can make you go to hell or that can make you become an enemy of God. Hallelujah. Let's proceed to Proverbs chapter 15, verse 20. A wise son maketh a glad father, but a foolish man despiseth his mother. How does a wise son make a glad father? Because he makes right choices. He does what is good. Whether a wise son or a wise daughter, both will make a glad father and also a glad mother, because they do wise things. They make right and good choices and grow up to become responsible people and successful people, not people who do embarrassing things. So the parents of such children will be glad, both when they are in the teenage or when they become young adults and after then. But a foolish man despiseth his mother. It's not just about a boy now. Even when you become a man, if you despise your mother or your father, the Bible says you are a foolish person. If you do not give respect or regard to your father or your mother, the Bible calls you foolish. Whether you're a man or a woman, God expects you to respect and honor your parents. If you want to be wise, that's the way to live your life. Hallelujah. Let's proceed to Proverbs chapter 17, verse 21. He that begetteth a fool doeth it to his own sorrow. The father of a fool has no joy. Children are supposed to be sources of joy for their parents. If a child, whether male or female, fails to walk in wisdom and does not operate in the light of the scriptures, is going to be a cause of sorrow for the parents, both the father and the mother. Hallelujah. That's why the scripture says here that he that gives birth to a fool does it to his own sorrow. And the father, and likewise the mother of a fool, has no joy. Don't forget, the fool has been defined earlier on as a child, whether boy or girl, who rejects correction, who rejects the reproof, the correction of his or her parents. Hallelujah. When your parents tell you don't walk with night marauders, whether night marauders or daytime marauders, don't walk with hooligans, don't walk with thieves, don't walk with drunkards, don't walk with fornicators and immoral people, don't allow sexually immoral boys or girls to be close to you, it is for your advantage. When they teach you don't smoke cigarettes, don't get involved with smoking hemp or using any hard drug, it is for your good and for your advantage. All those things have messed up a lot of lives. And a child who is wise will take to this teaching. And those who reject it do it to their own ruination. I pray that every one of you hearing me today will be made wise by the living God to obey the good counsel that your fathers and your mothers are giving you. Hallelujah. When a child fails to follow the good teachings of his parents and becomes a night marauder or daytime marauder, or a political thug, a hooligan, or a lady get pregnant without getting married, and all such things, it causes shame for the parents. Children, don't cause sorrow of heart. Don't cause shame for your parents. God gave you to your parents to make them glad. So do exactly that by walking in the counsel of the living God, by walking in the wisdom of God that your parents teach you or that you have found in the Holy Scriptures. Hallelujah. We stop here for today. Father in heaven, what are the words in the hearts of all the hearers? Let it save their souls into your kingdom. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen and amen.
This Word of Life program is coming to you through the mouth of God's servant, Oluwabamishi Akinduro of the Triumphant Church of Jesus Christ at 66A Lagos Abeokuta Expressway, Abekoko, Ifo, Ogun State, Nigeria. For further Christian life help, contact 0805-501-6597, 0805-501-6597 by SMS or WhatsApp, or email oluwabamishiakinduro@gmail.com, oluwabamishiakinduro@gmail.com, oluwabamishiakinduro@gmail.com. You can also call 0803-842-4075, 0803-842-4075, or 0803-695-4678, 0803-695-4678. Copies of this short sermon and other longer sermons in English language only can be sent to you free of charge by WhatsApp or email if you request for them. Join us for this Word of Life program, same day of the week, same time every week. Our Sunday morning service starts at 9 a.m. You are invited to fellowship with us. Jesus Christ is Lord. Amen and amen.